Good day to you all. In this video, I'm going to show you what happens when we go too short in the duty cycle of the pulses to the MOSFET on the motor circuit. As you can see, I have put much more capacity over here. So I have now 1 microfarad, 800 volts. You see 4 capacitors. They are each 1 microfarad and 400 volts, so they are 2 in series. So I have 1/2 of the microfarad, and then times 2 is 1 microfarad. The reason for that is because with the higher duty cycle, I of course have more current and more voltage to the LEDs in the negative path. So when we now start the circuit, then we see that this is our pulse. So this is 10 milliseconds. So we are now at 9 hertz and 6% duty cycle. Now when the switching goes too fast, you will see that we are gonna have a problem. So I'm only pulsing now one coil of the motor. This is the current. So I will show you what happens when I go higher in frequency. One moment, please. So when I go higher in frequency and the pulse duration is going less. You see the ringing starts. This is not good for the MOSFET and also not for the gate driver, because the blue is the signal to the gate and is coming from the gate driver. As you can see, we have some trouble. I'm not going to go lower because I don't want to blow up my parts again, but that is the reason. And when we go higher again, so you see when we go more duty for the pulse, I will go and try to go to the 5 hertz again. And I'm going to try now to change the duty cycle instead of the frequency. And you immediately see the ringing, and that is really bad for the components. So I am now at 5% duty cycle and 4%. And you immediately see the crap, and it is really not good for the MOSFET and the gate driver. So that is what I want to share with you, because normally with the kit comes the pulse pause. So with the timer option. I thought I had a print over here, but it's not the case. So you must keep in mind that when you work with the pulse, that you don't put the duty cycle too low, or you get that problem that I just showed you. So going to see for the next thing, because as you can see, I need bigger capacitors, so I have to order them, and I don't know when I'm going to get them. And also I'm going to use a different method. I'm not going to pulse the 4 coils at the same time. So with the Arduino over there, I'm going to try and pulse each coil separate, one after the other, so that the one coil has time to rest before it gets pulsed again. So it will be this one will be, so for the MOSFETs, this one will be pulsed, then this one, then this one, and then this one, each time when the magnet passes on the, or the sensor over there gives a signal for a pulse. So that is what I'm going to try, and you will see in the next movie if I'm succeeded or not. So hope to see you in the next movie, and thank you for watching.